Did you know Windows 12 may be coming as soon as the end of 2024? That's what the latest reports are saying. Windows Central released an article and they say they have sources that are saying that Microsoft is changing to a every 3 year cycle for a major new version of Windows. And at this point, it seems like it's a lot more than just speculation. We even have an apparent code name for Windows 12, which is Hudson Valley. Previously, the next version of Windows was just being called Next Valley. Now they actually have a name for it, so that kind of lends credence to that they really are getting closer to releasing this. Oh, and as for the thumbnail, of course it's a joke, but it does really seem like the Windows logos are getting a lot more simplistic over time. Now you might be thinking that doesn't it seem like they just released Windows 11? Why are they releasing a new one in just 3 years? Well, actually, Microsoft used to be on a 3 year schedule for releasing major versions of Windows, and that kind of changed with Windows 10, and I think it skewed a lot of people's perceptions because I have the dates here. So Windows XP was 2001, and then Windows Vista was actually a deviation from the norm and came out in 2007, but they were originally planning on releasing that in around late 2003, which would have been like 2.5 years. It just took way longer than they thought. And then Windows 7, again, was about 2.5 years in 2009. Then Windows 8 was 2012, 3 years later, and Windows 10 was 2015. So usually it's about every 3 years, or at least that's the plan. Sometimes they go longer, sometimes shorter, but that's the average. And that's probably what they're gonna go back to. Now, that doesn't mean they're not gonna release any kind of updates in between. Apparently, they're gonna go for an annual major feature update within each version. And then every 3 years would be like the major redesign. And actually, the yearly feature update thing has already happened. Before, you probably know that with Windows 10, they were releasing a major feature update every 6 months, whereas this past year, they switched to once a year, and there was no major feature update in the early half of 2023. It's going to be in the second half of 2023 for Windows 11. And apparently, even considering the annual major feature updates, they're supposedly going to release even smaller little feature releases every few months, possibly. So we saw that with the release of the weather widget. That was a pretty small thing, but they released it off schedule, I guess you could say. So we might see a little bit more of that going forward. And a lot of you are probably finding this pretty funny because most people apparently have not switched to Windows 11 yet even. And Steam did their recent hardware survey where Windows 10 had a 59.43% market share. Windows 11 was 35.75%. So by far, many people still use Windows 10. Maybe that's because of the system requirements, or maybe it was because Microsoft, in my opinion, definitely rushed to release Windows 11. It was really not that great at the beginning, very buggy. They did fix a lot of that at this point. I think it's fine, but you know, it's hard to get past the reputation. Just like with Windows Vista, it was fine by the end of it, but it kind of sucked. And we kind of know the meme where every other version of Windows is good and every other one sucks. And at this point, hopefully that actually holds true because the next version would be the good release according to that pattern. Now, as for possible features and changes with Windows 12, some people are speculating that it's going to be a complete build up from the ground up compared to Windows 11, which was like a basically reskinning of Windows 10. Under the hood, Windows 11 is just Windows 10 again. So it's possible that they're going to be redoing that, because one other thing that people have been talking about and reporting about is something called Core PC, which is going to basically be like a more modular version of Windows, which kind of Windows 10 was in a way, but maybe this is just even more so. And basically, it would allow Microsoft to adapt the Windows installation to the device. So you could have very basic Chromebook-like devices that really have not many resources and require a very lightweight operating system. They would have a more basic version of Windows 12, whereas a desktop PC would have the full thing. And to me, that does seem like something that might require a architectural change from a lower level than just changing the look of the OS. Now, as for features on the user-facing side, I think it's safe to say that it's going to be a lot of AI stuff. Microsoft has been partnering with OpenAI and really been pushing AI with Bing and the Bing Assistant. And even in recent dev versions of Windows 11, they have the Windows Copilot, which they announced a while ago. It's in basically beta with the dev channel of the Insider program, and it's basically like having the Bing chat assistant in Windows. Now, at the moment, I did try it out. I was not very impressed. At this moment, it basically is just taking the chat out of Edge and putting it on the side of Windows. You can use some commands, like asking it to change to dark mode, but if you ask it to do specific stuff, it doesn't even realize that it's in Windows 11 running in the desktop operating system. So you can ask it to do something and it'll say, I can't help you do that. I'm just a large language model, stuff like that, which is not helpful at all. Or it would even be better if it just said, I'm not able to do that yet. But at the moment, it just seems like it has no idea what you're talking about. So hopefully that gets improved. And depending on how the technology of AI progresses, it might even be possible that they integrate the AI directly into the operating system so it doesn't even have to send requests to the internet. Although I would kind of be surprised if they did that, because Microsoft requires you to be accessing the internet really to install it anyway. So they're probably going to want to have a lot more control over an AI model, just for safety's sake would be their argument. So all that being said, kind of the main thing I would really like to see is the AI having a much more hands-on ability with the operating system. So it could navigate through settings itself and look for stuff, and not just be able to do hard-coded pre-programmed things like changing the dark mode. That's not even that interesting. It's no more difficult than to go into the settings and change it there. But for example, if you could ask it, hey, I'm looking for that program I installed a while ago that did this, but I can't remember what it's called, and it knew what that was, that'd be pretty awesome. Or asking it maybe even to go and change some arbitrary setting, or maybe a setting within a program. Like you'd say, I can't figure out how to change this setting in Microsoft Word, and maybe it could navigate through those settings and literally find what you might be talking about. That kind of stuff would be really awesome, and I would like to see that. I'm sure that kind of thing will happen eventually, but will that happen in Windows 12? I guess we'll have to see. Probably not right away, hopefully soon. As for a redesigned UI, really the only thing we've seen is during one presentation Microsoft did, they showed off what looked like a new UI that had a floating taskbar. It wasn't pinned to the bottom. And then there were some icons at the top right and left of the screen, closer to what you see with macOS. So you had like the battery and stuff up there instead of at the bottom right, like the current taskbar is. So who knows how much of that we'll see, and also maybe more widgets. They added widgets in Windows 11, but it's kind of still just pinned to the taskbar. I'd really like to see stuff that you can pin to the desktop, kind of like we had in Windows Vista, but got rid of. I'm sure that kind of stuff will make a comeback. Though I would be really interested to know what you guys think. Does any of this excite you, or are you just going to stick to Windows 10 as long as you can? Or maybe there's some other features that I didn't mention that you would like to see, and that would just put you over the edge and definitely get Windows 12. Let me know that kind of stuff down in the comments. If you want to keep watching, the next video I'd recommend is where I was talking about the lost F13 through F24 keys on the keyboard. Did you know those used to exist? And actually, you can still take advantage of them. Definitely a cool video. I'll put that link right there you can click on. So thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.